Defense Updates has reached more than 150,000 subscribers. We're genuinely thankful to our viewers. You keep us going.
Follow us on social media. Support us on Patreon. All links in description below. Zumwalt-class warships, the U.S. Navy's largest and technologically most advanced class of guided missile destroyers, will be fitted with new long-range anti-ship missiles, according to the service's 2019 budget request, released on February 12. The U.S. Navy had requested $89.7 million to integrate Raytheon's SM-6 long-range supersonic missile and the subsonic long-range Maritime Strike Tomahawk, an anti-ship variant of the Tomahawk land attack cruise missile. The decision to change the mission requirements of the Zumwalt class from a land attack platform to surface warfare took place in November 2017. Although the option to expand the stealth destroyer's mission set by arming it with new long-range anti-ship missiles has been periodically discussed since the inception of the Zumwalt program in the 1990s. In this video, Defense Updates examines how Zumwalt class will be updated to be one of the most lethal ship killers in the world.
Number 5.
The Zumwalt-class destroyer is a class of United States Navy guided missile destroyers designed as multi-mission stealth ships with a focus on land attack. The class has a low radar cross-section because of design elements like wave-piercing tumble-home hull form whose sides slope inward above the waterline. The lead ship is named Zumwalt for Admiral Elmo Zumwalt and carries the hull number DDG-1000. Originally, 32 ships were planned, with $9.6 billion research and development costs spread across the class. As costs overran estimates, the quantity was reduced to 24, then to 7, and finally to 3, significantly increasing the cost per ship to $3.96 billion, excluding R&D costs, well exceeding the per-unit cost of a nuclear-powered Virginia-class submarine, $2.688 billion. The dramatic per-unit cost increase eventually triggered a Nunn-McCurdy amendment breach and cancellation of further production in April 2016. The total program cost was $22.5 billion, with an average cost of $7.5 billion per ship.
Number 4.
The 2019 U.S. Navy budget request reads, "As a comprehensive review of Zumwalt class requirements, Navy decided in November 2017 to refocus the primary mission of the Zumwalt class destroyers from land attack to offensive surface strike. The funding requested will facilitate this change in mission and add lethal offensive fires against targets afloat and ashore." Steve Stashwick noted back in December 2017, "Realigning the Zumwalt destroyers to conduct surface strike is consistent with initiatives like the U.S. Navy's distributed lethality concept, which seeks to mitigate its shipbuilding challenges by improving the offensive punch of individual ships that did not previously have potent sea combat capabilities."
Number 3.
The U.S. surface fleet has long led in its ability to provide air defenses over wide areas and launch devastating strikes against targets on land with the existing Tomahawk missile variants, but lags against potential adversaries in being able to sink other ships at long ranges. Russia and China have continued to design and introduce advanced, long-range, and high-speed anti-ship cruise missiles to defeat these sophisticated air defenses on modern warships. The U.S. Navy has long been conspicuous of having only the 1970s-designed Boeing RGM-84 Harpoon anti-ship missile to target enemy ships with. Compared to the most advanced adversary missiles like the Indo-Russian BrahMos, the Harpoon is slow with subsonic speed and has less than half the range with paltry 70 nautical mile strike capability. U.S. Navy wants to change this with SM-6 and Maritime Strike Tomahawk.
Number 2.
The U.S. Navy has had six SM-6, also known as the RIM-174A Extended Range Active Missile, ERAM, in service since 2013, but primarily as a traditional air defense weapon targeting air-breathing threats such as aircraft and cruise missiles. Since then, the weapons manufacturer, Raytheon, has been working with MDA to expand its capabilities to intercept both MBRM and shorter-range ballistic missiles in their terminal phase of flight as they fall onto their targets. It's only recently been deployed as an anti-ship missile. The Mach 3.5 Plus SM-6 has an effective range of approximately 250 nautical miles, or around 370 kilometers, outranging Harpoon anti-surface missile, and its speed is comparable to that of BrahMos missile. The SM-6 provides U.S. fleets with extremely lethal anti-ship option. It can discriminate targets using its dual-mode seeker, with the semi-active seeker relying on a ship-based illuminator to highlight the target, and the active seeker having the missile itself send out an electromagnetic signal. SM-6 fits into any standard vertical launch system, VLS, and Zumwalt-class has 80 of these cells.
Number 1.
The U.S. Navy has awarded a contract to fit an undetermined number of its long-range Tomahawk cruise missiles with upgraded sensors that will allow the land strike weapons to target ships. The idea is to inexpensively convert that existing Tomahawk Block 4 into this 1,000-mile anti-ship cruise missile that will be extremely survivable and effective. These maritime strike Tomahawks will provide a relatively low-cost anti-ship capability as the U.S. Navy works to make up for long-standing gaps in its ability to target adversary fleets. Unlike a typical Tomahawk missile, which, over the years, has been used to successfully target and destroy fixed targets such as enemy bunkers, static troop locations, command and control, as well as key infrastructure, the new Maritime Strike Tomahawk is specifically engineered with a next-generation ability to track and destroy moving targets at sea, Navy and Raytheon developers say. The Maritime Strike Tomahawk hinges on new seeker technology and faster computer processing speeds to engineer several modes wherein the Tomahawk can be retargeted in flight to destroy moving targets in the event of unforeseen contingencies. Like SM-6, Maritime Strike Tomahawk can also be launched from any vertical launch system. It will provide U.S. fleets with over-the-horizon engagement capability. Maritime Strike Tomahawk could be available for deployment in 2020.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.